And here is the Writer's Almanac for Tuesday, April the 28th, 2020. It's Harper Lee's birthday today, born Nell Harper in Monroeville, Alabama, 1926, who wrote the novel To Kill a Mockingbird, 1960. Mockingbirds, she wrote, don't do one thing but make music for us to enjoy. They don't eat up people's gardens, don't nest in corn cribs. They don't do one thing but sing their hearts out for us. That's why it's a sin to kill a mockingbird. It's the birthday of the poet Carolyn Forché, born Detroit, 1950. Grew up in a Catholic area out in the country. Went to school with the same 82 students for 12 entire years. Family was devout, lived by the liturgical calendar, lived in the same house almost all of her childhood with her parents, her Czech grandmother. But after she left home for college, she began to travel, went to Europe, then to Central America, went to Belfast during the Troubles there, spent time in South Africa during apartheid, also in Beirut. Even as a teacher in the United States, she was itinerant, taught in Arkansas, Virginia, New York City, and upstate. She thought she had inherited this nomadic nature from her Czech grandmother, who'd left Slovakia at the age of 11, worked in a needle factory to earn money to pay for her parents to come to America. When Carolyn Forché was growing up in Michigan, her grandmother would often disappear for 6 or 8 weeks at a time. Nobody knew where she went. She'd been visiting Mennonites in Pennsylvania or visiting Indians in other places. And so Carolyn Forché became a traveler. Her first poetry collection, Gathering the Tribes, came out when she was 26. The next year, she went to Spain to translate the work of an exiled Salvadorian poet. And then, when she got to Guggenheim, went to El Salvador to work as a human rights activist with Amnesty International. One day, she went to a prison where dissidents were held to draw a map of the prison. And to get into the prison, she had to pretend that she was visiting someone she knew. It was a risky maneuver. She made it out of the prison, which was gruesome, safely. She was very ill when she got out. She was upset. She was supposed to meet a group of young Salvadorian poets that night. She felt sick. She'd gotten sick on herself. She started to cry. She was afraid. But she went to the meeting. She met the poets. One of the poets, his wife, had just gone into labor and delivered a baby. And Carolyn Forché went up and found the baby wrapped in blankets lying in a cardboard box and half a dozen young poets there. And at that moment, she thought to herself, I'm never going to be tired again. I'm never going to complain. These people are risking their lives every day. And a few years later, she published her second poetry collection, The Country Between Us, which drew on her experiences in El Salvador. Her third collection, The Angel of History, won the LA Times Book Award. Here's a poem for today by Julie Kane, Used Book. What luck, an open bookstore up ahead as rain lashed awnings over Royal Street, and then to find the books were secondhand with one whole wall assigned to poetry, and then, as if that wasn't luck enough, to find between Jurel and Weldon Keys the blue-on-cream familiar backbone of my chapbook. Out of print since 63, its cover very slightly coffee-stained, but aging all in all no worse than flesh, through all those cycles of the seasons since its publication by a London press. Then, out of luck, I read the name inside, the man I thought would love me till I died. Used Book, poem by Julie Kane from Jazz Funeral. That's the Writer's Almanac for Tuesday, April the 28th. Funded by donations from listeners like you. Now available on PRX for distribution by your local radio station. Be well, do good work, and keep in touch.